Float switch floats on the water surface and move up and down and give output a digital contact signal. By using this signal, we can control the water level inside the tank. If we check the continuity of the wires of the float switch with a multimeter, as the switch goes down with the water level and takes a vertical position, the multimeter shows an open circuit between these two wires. As the water level goes up, the float switch floats on the water surface and takes a horizontal position, and its wire becomes shorted to each other, and multimeter shows the continuity between these two wires. Now, if we see inside the float switch, there is a micro switch, and a lever is connected to operate this micro switch. The wires are connected at the normal close contact of the micro switch. As the float switch goes down, the metallic ball moves forward and presses against the lever, and the lever operates the micro switch, and its normal close contact opens. Now, when the water level rises, the float switch moves upwards, and its metallic ball moves backwards, and it releases the lever, and micro switch resets again, and its contacts become close again. So this is how a micro switch operates. Now let's see the wiring and how we can use this float switch to control the water pump. First, we need a three position selector switch with two normal open auxiliary contacts so that we can run the pump in the manual and auto mode by setting this selector switch position. Next, we will take a control phase wire and connect it to the both of the normal open auxiliary contacts of the selector switch. From the output of the one auxiliary NO contacts, we will connect a wire directly to the coil of the contactor. This will turn on the contactor whenever we set the selector switch in the manual position. Next, from the output of the other NO contact, we will connect a wire to the common wire of the float switch. We will connect other wire of the float switch to the contactor coil. If we put the selector switch in the auto mode position, the pump contactor will turn on and off with the float switch signal. In the last, we will connect the three-phase pump wires to the pump contactor. Now let's test the circuit. As we turn on the selector switch in the manual mode, the pump contactor turns on directly. As we put the selector switch in the off position, the pump contactor turns off. If we put the selector switch in the auto mode position, now the contactor will wait for the float switch signal. As you can see that right now the water level in the tank is less and the float switch is hanging in the vertical position. The contact of the float switch is open right now, and it cut off the supply going to the contactor coil. That's why right now the pump contactor is off. As the water level rises inside the tank, the float switch floats on the water surface, and float switch operates once it is in the approximate horizontal position. Now the float switch contacts closes and it allows the electric supply to go to the contactor coil, and it energizes the pump contactor and pump turns on. So this is how we can control the pump with the float switch. If you like our videos, please share, like and subscribe, and till next time, take care and goodbye.